see how a proper design can be validated. Okay, so now what is validation? Basically, you're all engineers, no doubt. Valid, without valid reason or without a valid point or without validating anything, you can't go further. Okay, so now what is exactly validation when it comes to product and innovation? So when it comes to product and innovation, it is the process of gathering evidence and learnings around the business ideas through experimentation and user testing in order to make faster informed business decisions. The question here is, I have an idea, I have to make the product. So while making the product, though definitely I encounter a lot of problems, I might be technically strong. Sometimes I might not be technically strong, but I might be administratively this managerially strong, but I may not be. So these kind of things, resources. See, sometimes I don't need to be technically strong. I need some resources where people can help me. So identifying the wrong things, lacunas, then when you come out with a product, during the development of your product phase, what happens is the experimentation, what happens is the way how you projected your idea cannot be the same when it comes to the design. Your design completely changes from the way you have been approached in the experimentation. You have multiple iterations. That is very important. Okay. At the same stretch, this main approach has lots of objects. You require a lot of income and investment. Capital investment is large, right? But we are doing the same experiment for as many as number of times to see that whether we are having the same result. If there is any variant, you have to do it from the scratch again. That is the reason. Though budget is going, doing it from scratch will take lot budget than doing only just experiments. That is the reason. We do lot of budgeting in lean approach. Lean approach involves lot of capital investment to make sure that you have low risk. Okay. So this is multiple experiments we are doing in lean approach. Next, this is the most widely accepted approach, which is called as double down approach. And now we use it as much as, because this approach gives me exactly the pinpoint solution of what my idea is. Let us say I have come up with an idea. My last solution will meet exactly my idea. This is what double diamond approach is. So now if you observe, there are two diamonds. I will say you, all of them are you engineers. So I understand this session which is going, this triangle, whatever you are seeing, the first triangle, whatever you are seeing, that is called divergence session. And when it comes to a single point, then it is called as convergence session. Again, divergence,